Teddy Seezi Cheeye was 2 days shy of marking 1 year out of Luzira prison. And yet, when his friends and family thought that Cheeye's life was beginning to take shape and return to normal, the unthinkable happened. He died Thursday evening after he was knocked by a boda-boda cyclist. NTV spoke to Cheeye shortly after he was released from prison in March 2017. He recalled the conviction and the case that took him to prison, maintaining that he was framed because of the hard-hitting stories he wrote as a journalist in the 90s and early 2000s.
Because at that time they feared. So I have opened so many paths for journalism. So the price I paid was the price for journalism. All of these freedoms you see, whether it is a church, religion, the founders of freedom of worship were killed.
Cheeye's life was largely controversial, depending on who you asked. A passionate, bold, and one of the most fearless investigative journalists of his time, perhaps Cheeye's greatest contribution to this country was in journalism. He spent his life making the comfortable uncomfortable, with his no-holds-barred stories in his newsletter, The Uganda Confidential, that had the tagline, "The paper that splits the atom." Described by friends as courageous and bold, Cheeye never spared anyone with his pen.
I remember when I had just a waffle go to challenge me about drawing a cartoon of Museveni. He said, if you draw it, then you have made history. I drew the cartoon of Museveni my first time, and now they're drawing them, just they don't know who started it.
From the corridors of State House to the dungeons in slums, Cheeye's articles illuminated and dominated the front pages of the Monitor, and much more the Uganda Confidential that he owned. Cheeye's hard-hitting stories rubbed the authorities the wrong way. However, he later joined government, and that was the time his career hit a nosedive. He became a director in spy outfit, the Internal Security Organization, where he served as the director of economic monitoring. It was here that Cheeye got embroiled in a deep corruption scandal involving huge sums of donor funds. In 2009, Cheeye was convicted of embezzling 120 million shillings under the Global Fund. This is how some of his friends and colleagues describe Cheeye. According to retired journalist Joaquim Buembo, Cheeye was extremely aggressive, fearless, and a reformed person in the second phase that I met him while in jail. Even in jail, he remained passionate about economics. I was in his cell in prison for 2 hours. He was a very much read person. The media in the region owes him a lot of pushing and expanding the horizon of investigative journalism. He was the first to take the bull by the horns when he demystified the big man syndrome by exposing the ills the so-called big men had done. Charles Mwanguha, the bureau chief of the East African and TV host here on NTV, says, I remember Cheeye as a courageous journalist who led investigative journalism in the country, a person who had turned a page in his life and was clearly on the mend as a resource that the country needed after his stint in prison. Teddy says Cheeye's life should not be defined by the sentence he served, but rather his crusading around investigative journalism and economics. The CEO of the Independent magazine, Andrew Mwenda, says, and I quote, Cheeye was the first person under President Museveni's administration to stand firmly to expand democratic space in the country, most especially freedom of the media, and to hold the government accountable. He traded paths that nobody traded, and in that process, he inspired us young journalists then to be bold in holding the government accountable. While appearing on NTV's Fourth Estate 2 weeks ago, Cheeye spoke passionately about Uganda's journey to the middle-income status, poking holes in the government's grand plan.
In Uganda, for these last 30 years of Museveni, we have been pursuing the economics of locusts. The economics of locusts means when people get born in a country where you have swamps, you have trees, you go and cut the trees, sell timber, make money, build quality cars, build supermarkets. But you are borrowing from the future generation.
At the time of his death, Cheeye had revived the Uganda Confidential newsletter. And yet, for a man who has served about 10 years in prison, it appeared that at 60 years, his life had only just begun. Shillings, NTV.